मा सद्गमया तमसो मा ज्योतिर्गमया मृत्योर्मा अमृतंगमया ओम शांति शांति शांति। हेलो अगेन, आई वंस अगेन आई वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर दिस वंडरफुल इवनिंग। टुडे आई एम फीलिंग ब्लेस्ड एंड फॉर्चुनेट for sharing my experiences with you all. So all of you have acquired lot of knowledge from Dr. Udesha sir and his team in this lockdown period. And in this spiritual journey, all of you have gained lot of experiences through healing, meditation and retreats. In this journey, you may experience the importance of all this. Hope all of you have gained knowledge in this spiritual journey. So, Dr. Udesha has uplifted us through his abundance knowledge, and I want to thank you, all these SKM team members, once again. Hope all of you know about yoga. So based on that, today I will be doing some asanas which will be useful for you, which are related to chakras, which in turn helps to improve our aura, body aura. Now coming to this year, pandemic year, COVID-19, all of you have had that fear. It's an unforgettable year for all of us. In this time, Dr. Udesha has afflicted us through his abundance knowledge to overcome this situation, to go with the flow. And due to meditation and healing, we have overcome the fear. I hope so. Coming to today's session, I will be talking about chakras, asanas, and I'll be doing practical session. Later, I'll take you to Yoga Nidra meditations. Sir.
Perfect.
Slide.
So what I will do is, अब मैं क्या करने वाला हूँ कि स्लाइड डिस्प्ले करूँगा और ज्योति जी आपको एक्सप्लेन करेंगी कि स्लाइड में क्या क्या है और उसके बाद वो प्रैक्टिकल सेशन लेंगे। एक मिनट रुक जाइए, मैं स्लाइड को ओपन करता हूं। सेकंड, ज्योति जी इस स्लाइड विजिबल?
यस सर, विजिबल।
या सो यू कैन स्टार्ट
सर। सेकंड पेज,
वन सेकंड। Perfect. This is the first.
So you all know about chakras in human body and what are the 7 chakras. And today I will be telling you the facts of yoga and types of yoga, relation between these chakras and asanas. And I'll be doing practical session for these asanas. And last, I'll be doing yoga nidra meditation.
तो ज्योति मैडम आपको चक्रा के बारे में बताएंगी, योगा का फैक्ट्स बताएंगी, कितने टाइप के योगा होता है, रिलेशन क्या होता है चक्र और आसना के बारे में, और प्रैक्टिकल सेशन बताएंगे, और एंड में एक योग निंद्रा का मेडिटेशन बताएंगे।
कमिंग टू चक्रास, देयर आर 7 चक्रास एंड ऑल ऑफ यू नो अबाउट नाडीज। व्हाट आर दिस नाडीज? There are 114 junctions of nadis in our body. These nadis are the energy channels of prana in our body. These junctions are always in the form of triangles. You can see in the PPT. They are called chakras. Because they embody the movement from one dimension to other, they are referred as chakras. Now there are 112 inside our body and 2 are outside. Moving to next slide. And these 112 chakras arrange themselves in seven dimensions together to form seven chakras, and each having 16 aspects into seven, it will give 112 nadis in our body. That is in the PPT. You can see, sir. You can move the PPT towards left. No, sir. The third one. Sanjeev, sir.
You want the next PPT?
Scroll little up, sir. No, sir. Come back.
Okay.
Do you slide the?
You want more ahead? This is the first. Yes, this is the second page. This is the
third slide. Third slide. You should move slide little more towards left side, sir.
Left side. This is the maximum, I think, sir. Everybody can see everything.
But I can't see.
You arrange by your everybody can see, I think so. One second, I'll
just put a sense. Mute Maridin, ba. Mute Maridin, ba.
We can see. See, everybody can see. Everybody can see. Jyoti ji.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
So, regarding coming to these seven chakras. It is these seven dimensions which are generally referred to as seven chakras, which are in turn the basis for seven schools of yoga, that is seven colors in the rainbow. For human being to live a full-fledged of physical and social life, he needs only 21 chakras in his bodies to be active. Based on that, these 21 chakras are also connected with number seven. Because of three dimensions of energy, that is Pingala, Hida and Shushmana. There are seven sets each, and with three chakras functioning as one. So if 21 chakras are functioning physically, physiologically and emotionally, you will be complete. So based on this, next slide, sir.
One second. 1 minute.
Sir, next slide.
Yeah.
Yes. So now coming to yoga, as the name itself indicates, it is derived from Sanskrit word yug, which means to join or unite. Yoga is the union of individual soul with absolute or divine soul. When you experience everything as oneness in your consciousness, then you are in yoga. To attain that unity within you, there are many ways that we have to work with the body, then with breath, and then mind, then to our inner self. Means yoga means aligning body, mind and soul together in one line, so that we'll be connecting to oneness. When we are in meditation, we are already into yoga. The asana itself, yogasana. Sir, next slide. Now coming to types of yoga. Sir, can you move little?
Oh.
Sir, can you move little upward?
Actually, it is displaying. The problem is from your computer. You need to adjust. Everybody can see perfectly.
No. Okay, sir. Just 1 minute. Yeah. I'm still on the rate of market.
Angge brado, but adil brasta.
No, na adil thei ram mundu patane madakala.
Aal aagala ma display thosu deshto. Id banvod niru madakala.
Okay. So coming to types of yoga. Ikkada banu. Sir, there are four types of yoga, that is Karma Yoga, Kriya, Jnana and Bhakti. When these three dimensions are aligned in different directions, That means your mind is thinking and feeling in one way. Your physical body is going to in other way. Like this, all three dimensions will not lead to bhakti marga, that is devotional. In that way, if you come to karma, if you can joyfully involve yourself in any activities, that is karma yoga. If you do it with your great effort, only karma will come. No yoga will happen. Like that, kriya. Kriya also, with the path of kriya, you are not only seeking the realization, you also want to know the mechanics of life making. Like that, coming to jnana, we know what I know. What I do not know. I do not know. This is jnana. We'll be knowing jnana, but we'll not be into this path, direction. That is bhakti. If you use your emotions and try to reach the ultimate, we call this bhakti yoga. That means the path of devotion. Next, sir. Now, coming to chakras. As you all know about 7 chakras in our body, as it is displayed in the screen, you know, Mooladhara Chakra, Swadhisthana Chakra, Manipuri Chakra, Anatha Chakra, Vishuddhi Chakra, and Sahasra Chakra, Brahmarandra, that is Crown Chakra. Since all of you are aware of these chakras, where they are situated and in which color they are, so I just telling you the asanas which are related to these chakras, which will help you to release the blockages in these chakras. Coming to Mooladhara Chakra. Sir?
Yes. Next slide.
Yes, sir.
One second. 1 minute. One second.
Sanji, Bartana, you will have a Kashtagat Konakone, the Lake. Sanjo. And we'll keep it to the
Yes, we have come to the Mooladhara slide.
Okay, coming to Mooladhara Chakra, as you all know, it is the root chakra. Means in this chakra, for the asana for this chakra is mountain pose or warrior pose or balancing pose and Janu Sirsasana. By doing this chakra, the blockages in the Mooladhara Chakra will be released and it will help you to have good energy flow in your body. Means, if you can't do this asanas, you can use the mudra sign and practice while doing meditation. You can put affirmations and be in this pose. The affirmation for this is, I am safe. And by doing this asanas, the benefits are, it will improve your stability in yourself and physical and emotional level will be improved and it will clear the way for the survival. It means in this asana, it enables you to connect to the earth energy through 4 corners of the feet and sends upward energy to nourish the entire body. And it builds grounding and stability through legs. And it will remove all the obstacles on your way, clearing the path for powerful connection to yourself and your personal essence. Coming to second asana, that is sacral chakra or Swadhisthana chakra. In this chakra, you can do twisting pose, squats, triangular pose and Bharadvajasana twisting. In this, while doing this asanas, the blockages in this sacral chakras will be released and it will allow the energy flow from root chakra to sacral chakra so that our body will be active. The benefits of these chakras are, it helps to stimulate creation. It helps to connect to others, to find joy in life, and it also helps in reproductive organs. Coming to solar plexus chakra, that is Manipura chakra. The chakra is located, as you all know, above the navel, and in this chakra, when blockages is there in this chakra, it causes low self-confidence, ego, shame, increase in stress, and excess heat will be produced. And due to this, digestion problems will be there. So by practicing this chakra asanas, that is Silabhasana or Navasana, it will strengthen the stomach region and releases the blockages in the chakras, so that you will improve your willpower, personality and determinations, digestive systems, locomotion and eyesight. Coming to our chakra, in heart chakra, Bhujangasana, Ustrasana, Adomukha Shvanasana, that is Swan pose or Gadarasana pose. If you practice these asanas, it will help you to reduce the blockages in heart chakra. Or you can use the lotus mudras and practice this, those who can't do this, asanas, by putting symbols, Reiki symbols, Karuna Reiki symbols, money abundance symbols. It will help you to remove the blockages in the heart chakra, and you can practice this. It helps you to engage in intimate relationships, inviting love for yourself, like giving and receiving love. Feel compassion, generosity and respect. Moving to next chakra, that is throat chakra. Coming to throat chakra, in Vishuddhi chakra, you can do these asanas, that is Sarvangasana, Setu Bandhasana, Halasana and Pashva Konasana, and you can use this Jnana Mudra, and with affirmation, I am expressive. Many ladies face lot of problems in thyroid due to endocrine gland problems. If you practice these asanas, it will be helpful for them. By blockages in this throat chakra, there will be communication problem and also some ear, nose, throat problems related to that chakra. By practicing this throat chakras, it will help you to connect and listen to your inner voice, expression, speak, communication with others, confidence to speak in public in general. Next, coming to third eye chakra. In third eye chakra, as you all know, it is Agna chakra, means that I am connected. The mudra for this is Akini mudra. You can practice that also. And for this, asanas are very simple. You can use Balasana, the one we have displayed and mentioned there, or dolphin pose, Ardha Pincha Mayurasana. The center one is Balasana. And by practicing this, the benefits are, it will help you to see things clearly, insight, clear thoughts, clear intuitions. Those who have headaches, migraine, dizziness, negative illusions, negative thoughts in the mind, and any nervous system problems, they can practice this asanas. It will help you in releasing the pain, and releases the blockages in that chakra. Last but the least, that is crown chakra. In this chakra, Brahmarandra, for this we have to do Sirsasana and variations in Sirsasana or Baddha Konasana, that is butterfly pose. Can you see, sir?
Yes, I can see it perfectly.
Is it okay?
Yes, yes, I can see it clearly.
Okay. So, coming to this chakras, when there is a blockage in crown chakras, the causes are negativity in life, disconnected from spiritual trust, and wellness from your body, and also the benefits of practicing these chakras are high energy center, high conscious, higher consciousness, center for faith, peace and tranquility, positive attitude towards life. These are the benefits we are going to get by practicing these asanas. So before joining to retreat, I was not able to do this Sirsasanas. After joining for retreat and practicing Karuna Reiki symbols, money abundance and meditation, after healing sessions, I was able to connect to Sirsasana, which is a difficult pose. Through meditation only we can achieve this after continuous practice. It will be very helpful and useful. Sir.
Yes. Next slide.
Next.
1 second.
So, coming to the practical session, I'll be doing
stop the slide now.
Basic asanas I'm going to teach. What and all are mentioned in the slides. At first, I'm using VK Sangha's method. For elders, I'll be using chair asanas. And for younger ones, normal basic stretchings I'm going to teach for them. Yes, sir.
Should I repeat in Hindi?
This slide? Yes, sir.
Yes. I'll just stop the slide, okay?
Yes.
Kuch practical asanas batayenge, jo kar nahi paate buzur, jinko body ka problem hai, wo chair mein baith ke kar sakte hain, aur jo youngsters hai, unke liye stretching exercise karayenge.
So,
ye bahut badhiya hoga, aur ye pura session hum recording bhi kar rahe hain. तो आपको बाद में इजीली पता चल जाएगा. ओवर टू यू ज्योति जी.
यस सर.
आपको मैं स्पॉटलाइट में रख देता हूं. 1 second. सो पीपल कैन सी ओनली यू.
सर, आई वांट टू गिव इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ दिस प्रॉप्स.
हाँ, यू कैन गिव, यू कैन कंटिन्यू. No problem.
Sir, you should focus me, sir.
One second. I'll focus you. 1 second. Now it is focus.
Okay, sir. Sir?
Yes, tell me.
Okay, I want to explain about these props.
Yeah. You can continue, no problem.
In BK Sanger method, these props are used to practice yoga in a simple way so that it will be useful for our body to stretch completely. This is called brick and it is belt. This is a simple chair. You can order this in Amazon and you can purchase this if you want to practice these asanas. To start, for elders, basic asanas. I'll be teaching simple way using chairs. They can use any type of chairs what they have in their house, like this simple one or any type. Before asanas, make sure while placing the chair, the space should be free so that if they get hurt, they should be careful. Space should be free. To start with, first sit on the chair completely, fully inside. After sitting inside, should place your arms on your thighs. Make sure knees are parallel to each other and it should not cross above the ankle. After sitting in this posture, slowly lift your sternum up, roll your shoulders back, concentrate your eyesight on one point, and you can sit in this position for a few minutes so that you should keep pressing your foot to the floor. And in this asana, you can use Reiki symbols, Karuna Reiki symbols, and Money Abundance symbols, and you can chant any mantras while sitting in this posture.
हाथ के जो शोल्डर है वो पीछे रखना है और दोनों पैर को जमीन पे टच करना है. यस यू कैन कंटिन्यू ज्योति.
सर, आर यू एबल टू सी माय फुट कंप्लीटली?
नो, आई कांट सी योर फुट कंप्लीटली.
नाउ?
यस, नाउ 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 वी कैन सी परफेक्ट. नाउ इट इज विजिबल.
ओके सर. Now, coming to second one, slowly you should sit in the edge of the chair like this. Again, placing the foot on the floor. Make sure knees are parallel to each other. You should not cross your ankle. Afterwards, slowly keep your left hand below your thigh region of the right hand leg. Turn, keep your right hand on the arm of the chair and twist towards the right side.
आप देख सकते हैं कि ज्योति जी कैसे ट्विस्ट कर रहे हैं कुर्सी पे बैठ के. हाँ, ज्यादा स्ट्रेच नहीं लेना, जितना आप स्ट्रेच कर सकते हैं उतना ही स्ट्रेच करना है. अपने आप को ज्यादा स्ट्रेस मत देना.
Those who can't bend their elbows, they can straighten it, straighten the elbow region and should be straight.
आपका बाया हाथ स्ट्रेट होना चाहिए. आप देखोगे बाया हाथ राइट लेग पे टच हो रहा है पाम, और जो राइट हाथ है वो कुर्सी पे टच हो रहा है. परफेक्ट.
अगेन सेम टुवर्ड्स लेफ्ट साइड, प्लेस योर राइट हैंड बिलो योर लेफ्ट थाई, कीप योर लेफ्ट हैंड ऑन द चेयर. अगेन यू शुड स्लोली टर्न टुवर्ड्स so that your shoulders should be aligned in one line.
आपके जो हाथ के जो शोल्डर है उसको परफेक्टली पीछे की तरफ रखना है. बाया हाथ लेफ्ट हैंड जो चेयर के पीछे होगा, और राइट लेग आपका राइट हैंड आपका लेफ्ट लेग पे टच होता है. और ज्योति जी जैसे पोज दिखा रहे हैं वैसे हमें करना है.
You can stay in each asanas for 1 minute so that there will be complete stretching of in your shoulders, twisting in your back region and hip region, and your foot will be grounded to the floor. So you should keep pressing.
दो चीज हमेशा ध्यान रखनी है. आपके जो पैर की हथेली है, पैर के जो ये है, पैर के दोनों पांचों उंगलियां या पांचों पांचों 10 उंगलियां वो जमीन पे टच होनी चाहिए. और जो भी आप पोज लेते हैं उसको होल्ड करके रखना है मिनिमम 1 मिनट. 1 मिनट होल्ड करेंगे तो ही उसमें पावर बढ़ेगा. हमें फास्ट नहीं करना है. ये आसना कभी काम करता है जब हम कोई भी आसन को होल्ड करके रखते हैं.
दिस आसना इज यूजफुल फॉर सैक्रल चक्रा. It will strengthen your pelvic region and your reproductive system.
ये आपके स्वादिष्टान चक्र को स्ट्रॉन्ग बनाता है, मतलब नाभि से चार उंगली नीचे आपका रिप्रोडक्टिव सिस्टम जो होता है उसको भी वो स्ट्रॉन्ग करता है.
Then coming to third, turn towards, sit towards your right side of the chair. Sit in the edge of the chair like this. Again, the with one foot difference between the two legs. So that
दोनों पैर के बीच में थोड़ा गैप रखना है.
Make sure your legs will come outside like this while turning. It should not move from this place. It should be in that place. Now slowly turn towards right side. You should hold both the in both the hands. You should hold the arm of the chair.
दोनों हाथ चेयर को टच करना है. चेयर का जो आर्म है उसको टच करना है. आप ध्यान से देखिए कि ज्योति जी कैसे पोज बता रहे हैं और उसको होल्ड करके रखना है एक मिनट तक.
Those who have flexibility in their shoulders, they can place their right hand on the chair backside like this after twisting.
जो ज्यादा फ्लेक्सिबल है वो राइट हैंड को और ज्यादा पीछे मोड़ सकते हैं. आप देख सकते हैं कि ज्योति जी ने कैसे पोज किया है. अगर कर सकते हैं तो अपने आप को फोर्स नहीं करना है.
सेम थिंग आई विल रिपीट फॉर लेफ्ट साइड.
यस, हमने राइट चेयर के कोने में बैठ के राइट साइड घुमाया था. अभी लेफ्ट चेयर के कोने में बैठ के लेफ्ट साइड घुमा रहे हैं. आप देख सकते हैं और ये आसन करते वक्त उसको होल्ड करके रखना है. एनर्जी कब राइज होती है? जब हम कोई भी आसना को होल्ड करके रखते हैं, पकड़ के रखते हैं.
When they are in this posture, they can use all the symbols and they can chant mantras. While in this asanas, they can do like that.
आसना के साथ साथ में जब होल्ड करते हैं तो आप हीलिंग के सिंबल्स डाल सकते हैं और साथ में मन में मंत्र भी चैंट कर सकते हैं.
Now I'm sitting completely inside the chair.
Jyoti ji, one question they are having. What should be the breathing technique? Breathing should be normal?
I'm holding the front leg.
They are asking me what about the breathing? Breathing should be normal?
Yes, we should inhale slowly and exhale. While doing asanas, they should inhale through the nose and exhale through the nose.
Okay, so the most important thing, जब भी आप ये आसना करते हैं तो इनहेल और एक्सेल मतलब सांस अंदर और बाहर नाक से ही लेना है, मुंह का उपयोग नहीं करना है. यस, परफेक्ट.
सैक्रल चक्र, मणिपुर चक्र. You should sit completely inside the chair. I'm holding the front legs of the chair. While coming down, our tummy should rest on the thighs and you should lift the sternum up. Slowly you should bend down. Those who can't, let them bend according to their capacity. Otherwise, they'll strain their back. So, slowly you should come down holding the edges of the chair rod, front end, so that when they keep lifting their shoulders up and neck should be facing upwards.
दोनों हाथों को चेयर के फ्रंट में पकड़ना है और सिर और शोल्डर को ऊपर की तरह खींचना है. आप देखिए ज्योति जी कैसे आसना दिखा रहे हैं. इस पे आपको बहुत सा स्ट्रेच आएगा.
And you should slowly inhale and exhale while doing asanas. You have to concentrate on your breath.
अब जो भी आसना करते हैं, पूरा ध्यान अपनी सांसों पर होना चाहिए. जस्ट कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन योर ब्रेथ. अपनी सांसों पर ही ध्यान देना है. ये इतना सिंपल वे में ज्योति जी आपको एक्सरसाइज करा रही है चेयर में बैठ के, ये कोई भी कर सकता है. प्लीज इसको 100% इंप्लीमेंट कीजिए.
Those who can't go for walking, those who can't do any exercise, they can make use of the chair, and if they practice that, it will benefit for their health.
जिनको फिजिकल प्रॉब्लम बहुत है वो चेयर में बैठ के भी ये सब आसना कर सकते हैं, जो कि बहुत यूजफुल और सिंपल है लेकिन बहुत इफेक्टिव है.
Those who are having any pillows or bolsters like this, they can place it like this on the chair, placing your foot, one foot apart between two legs, 1 feet apart, standing straight. Slowly you should come down, bending slowly, lifting your chest up. First you can keep your hands on your hip region. And you can slowly bend down like this, and you can place your forehead on this. Those who can't bend down, they can place it like this.
कितना अच्छी तरह से उन्होंने समझाया है. दोनों पैर में डिस्टेंस 1 फीट का होना चाहिए. दोनों हाथों को कमर की तरफ पकड़ लेना है. छाती और आपके शोल्डर स्ट्रेट होने चाहिए. तकिया चेयर के बीच में डाल दीजिए और बेंड हो जाइए, और आपका सिर तकिए को टच करना है. जितना झुक सकते हैं उतना ही झुकना है.
Those who are flexible, they can leave the hand down, and otherwise they can place their chest on this like this, and they can stay in this pose for few minutes.
जो अगर flexible है और easily कर सकते हैं, वो अपने छाती को तकिए की तरफ लेके जा सकते हैं, जैसे ज्योति जी ने दिखाया है, और दोनों हाथों को फोरआर्म्स को चेयर की तरफ टच कर सकते हैं. ब्रीदिंग नॉर्मल ब्रीदिंग होनी चाहिए, लेकिन जो नो ब्रीदिंग करते हैं वो नाक से होनी चाहिए, मुंह से नहीं करना. नॉर्मल ब्रीदिंग. ब्यूटीफुल, वेरी नाइस आसना.
दैट वन इज फॉर हार्ट चक्र.
ये हार्ट चक्र को परफेक्टली एक्टिवेट करता है.
दोस हु कैन बेंड फॉरवर्ड, दे कैन कीप देयर फोरहेड डाउन. Hands in a cup shape.
जो बेंड इजीली कर सकते हैं वो तकिए को निकाल के सिर को खुर्ची की तरफ टच कर सकते हैं और हाथों को जमीन पे टच कर सकते हैं. लेकिन जो कर सकते हैं वो ही नहीं, तो सिंपल आसना है कि तकिए को लगा के तकिए पे टच करना है.
Coming to the back of the chair, again, those who have problems in headache, any head, for third eye chakra, this one is for third eye chakra.
अभी जो एक्सरसाइज करा रहे हैं वो आग्नेय चक्र, जो थर्ड आई चक्र, जहाँ पे आप बिंदी टिक्की लगाते हैं, उसको एक्टिवेट करने के लिए ये एक्सरसाइज है.
Slowly, keeping your hand, both the hands on the chair, pressing it, slowly you can place your forehead on the chair arm.
दोनों हाथों को चेयर पे टच करना है. दोनों पैर तो जमीन पे टच है और सिर चेयर का जो ऊपरी हिस्सा है वहां पे आपका आग्नेय चक्र फोरहेड है, उसको टच करना है. आप ये आसना को देख सकते हैं, इसका फोटो भी निकाल सकते हैं. होल्ड करके रखना है, जो भी हम आसना करते हैं उसे होल्ड करके रखिए.
Slowly you have to breathe and inhale and exhale.
सांसें धीरे धीरे अंदर लेनी है नॉर्मल और सांसें बाहर छोड़नी है. पूरा ध्यान अपनी सांसों पर ही रखना है.
By doing this, full whole body will be stretching and you can feel the stretching and the pain in the head will be relaxed. Sinus or headache problem, it will be reduced.
Migraine, vertigo, sinus, ये सब problem में समाधान देता है ये एक्सरसाइज.
And those who have got any back problem or upper shoulder region, any neck related, this part if they have pain, it's not flexible, if it is tightness is there, then they can do this asana. Slowly standing in this posture, rolling the shoulders back, slowly they can hold the upper arm of the chair and then they feel the stretching.
जिनको शोल्डर का प्रॉब्लम है वो ये आसना कर सकते हैं. शोल्डर स्टिफ हो जाते हैं, अपर बैक जो हमारा ऊपरी हिस्सा है बैक का वो पेन करता है, तो ये एक्सरसाइज जो ज्योति जी बता रहे हैं वो एक्सरसाइज से उसमें समाधान मिलेगा. ये जो भी आसना करते हैं उसमें जैसे मैंने पहले भी बताया आप सिंबल और मंत्र का उपयोग कर सकते हैं.
And they can stay in these asanas for 1 to 2 minutes.
आप 1 मिनट मिनिमम से लेके 2 मिनट भी आसना पे बैठ सकते हैं, मतलब आसना पे होल्ड कर सकते हैं.
They can sit like this completely inside the chair.
Next exercise है वो chair पे देखो कैसे बैठी है, दोनों पैर को बाहर निकाला है.
Again, you can stretch, twist your shoulders like this.
Right side में उन्होंने twist किया है. लेफ्ट साइड की तरह ट्विस्ट किया है.
दे कैन डू त्रिकोण आसनास. Standing little away from the chair, just keep your legs 3 feet apart. Slowly turn your left foot. Keep your pressing your arm on the chair. You can bend down and lift your leg up. Ardha Chandrasana.
आप देख सकते हैं कैसा आसन लिया है उन्होंने, लेफ्ट हैंड को चेयर की तरफ 90 डिग्रीज में, पैर भी देखो 90 डिग्रीज में है.
डिपेंडिंग ऑन देयर फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी दे कैन स्ट्रेच एंड दे कैन स्टे इन दैट पोज फॉर देयर कंफर्टेबिलिटी अकॉर्डिंग टू देयर कंफर्ट.
परफेक्ट.
Using belt or any dupattas also, they can use this dupatta or belt and they can do stretching exercises. At first, I'll show you.
अगर आपके पास belt नहीं है तो आप dupatta का भी use कर सकते हैं.
You can place the belt in the left foot like this. And slowly they can keep the foot on the chair. Slowly bending towards left side. holding the belt, and they can feel the stretch in the arms and side of the tummy region.
आपको साइड में टमी रीजन में प्रेशर आएगा.
एंड दे कैन ट्विस्ट देयर राइट शोल्डर्स बैक. एंड यू शुड नॉट बेंड, पुट योर हेड डाउन, यू शुड बी स्ट्रेट अप.
आपको सीधा देखना है, बेंड नहीं करना है, आपके सिर को लेफ्ट की तरह झुकाना नहीं है.
I'll do. Nobody should try this without practice. I'm just showing this for thyroid problems. Those who can do, they can do using this chair. They can sit comfortably inside the chair, raising the legs forward. Slowly, they should place the back on the chair. Resting the head downwards, placing the arms on the thighs. Should close your eyes and stay in this position. You can stay in this pose for 2 to 3 minutes so that there will be complete body stretch from head to toe.
बहुत बढ़िया एक्सरसाइज है ये.
Those who are comfortable, they can leave their hand down.
दोनों हाथ को भी रिलैक्स कर सकते हैं.
During practice session, they'll be having the body pain due to stretching action. It will slowly reduce after 1 week of practicing. Initially, there will be a pain in the body. Sir.
Yes.
This is enough for elders. They can practice
perfect,
this.
Perfect. It's around 7 o'clock. ये elders के लिए जो बुजुर्ग है उनके लिए ये आसना बहुत सिंपल है और बहुत इफेक्टिव है.
For all of them, I'm using bricks and doing some standing and sitting asanas. Those who are flexible, they can do without these props also. At first, I'm standing in Samasthiti.
आपका पैर नहीं दिखाई दे रहा है. I can't see your legs. Yes, now we can see. Perfect, perfect.
Can you see my foot, sir?
Yes.
At first, standing in Samasthiti. To stand in Samasthiti, should touch your toes, ankles, knees should be touching each other. You should roll your thighs inside and you should tuck your tummy. Tucking the tummy means you should pull your stomach in and push your buttocks down. And slowly rolling your shoulders back so that your palm will be facing downwards, pointing towards the ground. Now stretching your neck region, focus your eyesight on one point. This posture is called as Samasthiti, that is Tadasana. Before going to any asanas, you have to be in this pose for a few minutes so that you will be balanced, there will be a balance throughout the body. You can feel the body weight. It will be equally balanced. During this pose also, you can put affirmation and concentrate on your breath. It helps you to build up stamina in your body by balancing the whole body weight.
कोई भी आप आसना करते हैं तो ये आसना से स्टार्ट करना है, ताड़ासना बोलते हैं, जिसमें पैर दोनों पैर जमीन को टच, हाथ स्ट्रेच करना है, शोल्डर स्ट्रेट इरेक्ट, और आपका पूरा ध्यान एक पॉइंट पे होना चाहिए स्ट्रेट.
Slowly relax and release. Now, first I'll be doing Uttanasana, means bringing both the hands upwards, so that you should keep pulling your hands upwards, your shoulders should bring down in a straight line, and your chest region should be pulled upwards, so that your spine will be straight. This is called Uttanasana.
दोनों हाथों को ऊपर स्ट्रेच करना है और पैर दोनों पैर जमीन को टच होंगे, स्ट्रेट होंगे.
While pulling up your arms, your elbows should be locked. Means you should not bend like this, and it should not be away from your ears. It should be straight. And you know the stretches. You can feel the stretches in your hand, arms.
दोनों हाथों को बेंड की तरह ऊपर नहीं करना, दोनों एल्बो स्ट्रेट ऊपर होने चाहिए.
This is called Paschima Namaskara. I'll show you. Placing both the hands behind your back, like Namaskara posture, rolling your shoulders back so that can say Namaskara. This is called Paschima Namaskara.
अगर आप पीछे नहीं कर पाते, बहुत लोगों को ये डिफिकल्ट है, तो आप
you can slowly place it down. If they can't, if they're not flexible initially, and slowly they can place it later. One plank like this. Turning towards again, these asanas will help you in stretching this chest region. Good rest, breathe for the lungs and shoulders. Strengthening of the shoulders, it will help. And slowly bending down, you should jump towards 3 feet apart, turning the foot towards right side. And left leg also, we can. Paschima Namaskara.
ये Paschima Namaskara है आसना का नाम.
Can bend slowly down, lifting your head up.
धीरे धीरे bend होना है.
While bending down, you should lift your chest up so that you not get spine injuries. You should be careful while bending down. Otherwise, you can stay like this up.
जितना बेंड हो सके है उतना ही बेंड करना है, ज्यादा स्ट्रेस नहीं लेना है.
Again, I'll show some sitting asanas, that is Dandasana and Bharadvajasana twisting. While using for sitting asanas, they can use bricks. Can you see, sir?
Yes, I can see you. I can see you properly.
You can place the bricks. Sir, can you see the sitting posture?
Yes, yes, I can see the brick also.
Now?
Now I can see, yes. Perfect, perfect.
Placing the brick, you can sit on this. Like this. This is called Tadasana. Sorry, Dandasana.
इसको दंडासना बोलते हैं.
Stretching again, you should roll your hands back, placing your arms on the thighs, can be in this posture, so that you should press your thigh regions towards the floor, touch your foot, ankle, and you can feel the stretches while doing this asanas in the leg region. And you should keep lifting your sternum up. Okay. For Bharat Bhujasana twisting, we can place the right leg towards left leg towards right side. You can place the right leg on the left side in a cross shape. The ankle should rest on the left foot. Again, bringing the right hand up, slowly placing it towards the thigh region and slowly twisting back. And look towards your left side. Then again, towards right side, slowly bring your hands up, place it on your knees, right knee, and again you should touch back, turn back and look towards your right side. Slowly release and relax. Sir.
Yes.
Using bridge, they can go to bridge pose. Should I show you that? Can I show?
Yes, yes, you can show it. No problem.
First, lying down on the back. Slowly, you can place this leg near your lower back so that this pose is called bridge pose.
ब्रिक सपोर्ट देता है, इसके लिए हम ब्रिक का यूज करते हैं. ब्रिक को आपने देखा होगा कहाँ पे प्लेस किया है, जिससे इजी हो जाता है.
So that with the big support, we can stay in this pose for 2-3 minutes.
Ye
the complete stretch will be there in thigh region, stomach area, and the upper part of the shoulder area, chest region.
ब्रिक के वजह से आप ये आसना में 2-3 मिनट रह सकते हैं. ब्रिक नहीं रहेगा तो आप ज्यादा टाइम नहीं रह पाएंगे. Yes, yes, you can do. Once we are comfortable, you can do without the brick also.
And using bricks, they can do Vajrasana.
ये ब्रिक से भी वज्रासन कर सकते हैं.
Placing the brick, they can sit on the brick. Depending their height requirements, they can place it horizontally or vertically. Placing that, they can sit in Vajrasana.
Vajrasana,
those who can't bend their knee, those who are having knee problem, they should not do this posture. It will hurt their knees.
जिनको knee का problem है, उनको ये आसना नहीं करना है, bend नहीं करना है knee को.
Using this, they can come to child pose easily. Slowly, they can bend down. This is for third eye chakra.
Third eye chakra ko activate karta hai. आग्नेय चक्र को एक्टिवेट करता है.
नाउ यूजिंग ब्रिक फॉर यूजिंग ब्रिक दे कैन सिट इन बद्ध कोणासना फॉर रूट चक्र.
बटरफ्लाई पोज.
Otherwise, they can keep their hands towards like this in triangle pose and can keep their head on their foot. This is for crown chakra.
ये crown chakra को activate करता है. ये crown chakra को activate करता है. Butterfly flow, butterfly pose. अगर आप सिर को हेड को नीचे टच करते हैं जैसे ज्योति जी ने किया है, जैसे ज्योति जी ने किया है वैसे आप करते हैं, जिससे क्राउन चक्र एक्टिवेट होता है. वेरी नाइस.
Using this breath, we can do Parshva Uttanasana. Placing the brick in front of you like this or like this, depending on the flexibility, keeping foot 3 feet apart, slowly bringing both the legs inside 30 degrees, placing the hands in the hip region, they can slowly bend down. Otherwise, if you are comfortable, they can hold the knee.
ये अगर आप कर सकते हैं या आप अगर इजीली कर सकते हैं तो करना है, नहीं होता है तो जबरदस्ती ये आसना को नहीं करना है.
These are all for root chakras, stretching chakras, basic आसनास.
ये रूट चक्र को एक्टिवेट करता है.
और त्रिकोणासना एंड वीरभद्रासना आल्सो दे कैन यूज दिस ब्रेक.
परफेक्ट.
बाय टर्निंग देयर फुट 90 डिग्री बोथ द लेग्स देयर इट शुड बी लॉक्ड प्लेसिंग टर्निंग टुवर्ड्स राइट साइड सो दैट hips should be in center, left leg straight, locking their knees, right leg straight, slowly coming forward, they can keep their hands on the brick, pressing the brick, slowly they can bring the hands up and look towards their hand.
क्या उपयोग कर रहे हैं? राइट हैंड ब्रिक को टच किया ईट को और लेफ्ट हैंड देखो कैसे स्ट्रेच किया है. वेरी नाइस. आपको एक सवा घंटे में कितना सीखने को मिल गया है
सर?
यस.
टाइम इज देयर?
इट्स 7:15.
इज देयर टाइम स्टिल?
वी हैव टू गो विद निद्रा मेडिटेशन आल्सो राइट?
Yeah.
So, whatever you say, if you want to extend, you can for 3-4 minutes, 5 minutes, no problem.
Should I continue?
Yeah, you can. Any other asanas are left?
Two more are there.
So you can continue, no problem. Complete both asanas.
Coming to Samasthiti, again, bend your knee, place your foot 3 feet apart. Slowly turn your right leg and then left leg inside 30 degree, keeping your hip region in the center. Slowly bring your leg towards right side, slowly bend so that you can stretch little more, you are flexible. Coming down like this in sitting posture. You can place the hand on the thigh region. Slowly, they can lift the hand up and see the thumb of the left hand. this pose also is good for thyroid problems. Parshvakonasana. And again, those who are flexible, they can keep the right hand down and stretch the left hand up. Slowly bring down, left hand down. Slowly jump back to Samasthiti. Again, one more asana for in standing position. This is called squatting. Please keep your foot 1 feet apart. Slowly. Hands up. Sit down like how you sit on the chair. So that you should keep pulling your hands upward and hips down. This is called Utkatasana. Also, we can do Janusirasasana in sitting posture. Using big, you can sit here, placing leg, left leg forward, placing right leg on the thigh region. It should be in 90 degree angle. Slowly, they can lift both the hands up. This is called Janusirasasana. Keep pulling your hands up, shoulders rolling back, spine should be straight, thighs should be pressing towards left leg, placing your toes. It's called Janusirasasana. Slowly release and relax. Sir, is that okay?
Perfect, perfect. Perfect. Yes. Very nice.
Can I continue with asanas?
No, we can start with the nidra, right? It's already.
Yes. Move the slides, sir, back.
So you want to slide again?
Yeah, last slide.
1 second.
Yes.
1 second.
Group ali da din kora.
Group ali.
Main group kora.
Yes. Can you see the slide?
Yes, sir. Last one. Can you scroll it up?
You need to do that. Here it is perfectly. You need to adjust on your computer.
I can't move it, sir.
Here everybody can see, I think so. It's full screen.
Can all of us see? Coming to last asana, that is Savasana. You can never underestimate the art of relaxation. This Savasana can be the most difficult pose for your practice. In this asana, the pose sets up the condition that allowed you to gradually enter a truly relaxed state, one that is deeply refreshing in itself and that also can serve as a starting point for meditation. And the essence of savasana is to relax with attention, to remain conscious and alert while still being at ease. Remaining aware while relaxing can help you being to notice and release long-held tensions in your body and mind. So, while doing this savasana, you can go deep into meditation. That is called yoga nidra meditation. And while doing this, you should put your mobile in silent mode and make sure in that posture your body will not move and you can sit in any comfortable or lay down position. Can we start that, sir?
Yeah, so I'll stop this sharing and I'll start with the video. 1 second. 1 minute.
After coming to the position, you should not change your body.
Can you hear the voice?
You should be in a suitable, comfortable position.
Can you hear it?
So, all of you sit in any suitable positions or lay down on the floor. Once after coming to the position, you should not change your body or move your body. For that, place your palms upwards facing the sky and legs should be completely relaxed. Now slowly concentrate on your breath. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. First, for Omkara, there are three words come together. Repeat with me loudly. Once again. Next. Ooh. 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 Next. Any affirmations, what you want to manifest in your body, and remember these words. Now, put all the symbols you have learnt in reiki, karuna reiki, psychic surgery, money abundance. And for the people who have not learned, imagine white light is flowing inside your body through your crown chakra in the form of bright beam of rays. Now, slowly bring your vision towards your foot. Slowly inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Tense your left foot. Concentrate on your toes, ankle region, and entire foot. Tense, relax. Once again, tense, relax. Release. Now, bring your vision towards your calf muscle, chin bone of your left leg. Slowly tense, relax, tense, relax. Now move towards your knee region. Tense, relax, tense, relax. Towards your thigh muscles. Tense, relax, tense, relax. Now move towards your right leg. Bring your vision towards your foot on your toe.
Sir, no voice.
Again, move your vision towards your neck region. Completely stretch your neck. Tense it. Feel the neck portion completely, both upwards and backwards. Tense and relax. Tense and relax. Now, moving slowly again towards your face part. Bring your vision towards your eyes. Rotate your eyes up and down. Tense it. Relax. Tense it. Relax. Now, towards your nose. Just keep tensing your nose, means pressing it, holding for few minutes, few seconds. Relax. Tense it. Relax. Now, towards your forehead. Tense. Relax. Tense. Relax. Now, towards your cheeks and chin. Tense. Relax. Tense. Relax. Now, slowly towards your lip region. Tense it. Relax. Tense it. Relax. Now, towards your ear region. Tense. Relax. Tense. Relax. Now, towards your upper brain and complete entire head portion. Focus completely to your front lobe, back lobe, side lobe, and entire part of the head region. Tense, release, relax. Tense, release, relax. Now, towards back region. Upper back, middle back, and your lower back. Tense, release. Tense, release. Tense, release. Relax. Relax your entire body. Take deep breath. See the blood flow in your body completely, and energy flowing in your body from head to toe. Relax, relax, relax. Now, slowly imagine, breathe again, once again. Inhale, relax. Inhale, relax. Imagine you're sitting under a beautiful tree near a green mountain. Again, take deep breath. Breathe. Relax. Breathe. Relax. Breathe in. Relax. Release completely. Make it fast. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. breathe in, breathe out. Release, relax. 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 Enjoy that peace in you. Enjoy that moment in you. Now, imagine a beam of white light is projecting towards you from the mountains. Keep observing it. Keep observing it. Breathe in, breathe out. Observe the deep light projecting into your forehead in the form of white light. And this projecting light behind the rise of the mountain is rising deep into infinity. Keep observing that light rising into infinite. Now, breathing in, focus into your affirmations. And feel it has been accomplished. See it clearly. Imagine that it has been manifested and you are in complete joy. Feel the joy of it. And well-being. Feel the power of it. And that spreads around you. Keep breathing slowly. Keep breathing slowly. Relax, relax. Now, slowly bring your awareness to your outer world. Keep breathing. Inhale, exhale. Sarve bhavantu sukhinah. Om sarve santu niramaya. Om sarve badrani pashyantu. Om ma kashita dukha bhagvate. Om sarve sta swastira bhavatu. Sarvesham shantira bhavatu. Om sarvesham purna bhavatu. Om सर्वेषां मंगल भवन्तु ओम शांति 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 Now, slowly bring your hands towards your eyes. Rubbing it, place it on your eyes in a cup shape. Release, relax. Open your eyes gently. Hope all of you enjoyed.
Hello, you can unmute yourself, Jyoti ji.
Hope all of them enjoyed.
Yes,
that's it.
Very nice, very nice. One or two questions only, because we have already late. Anybody wants to ask Jyoti ji can ask. Any question you want to ask, you can type on question and answer group. वहां पे आप पूछ सकते हैं और आपकी क्वेरी सब क्लियर हो जाएगी. बहुत सिंपल सा उन्होंने योगा बताया है चेयर के थ्रू, जो बुजुर्ग लोग भी इजीली कर सकते हैं विदाउट एनी ट्रबल, और उनको भी बहुत अच्छा इफेक्ट आ जाएगा. अच्छा, एक क्वेश्चन ले लेते हैं. कविता जी का क्वेश्चन एक ले लेंगे. कविता जी, आपको मैंने अनम्यूट कर लिया है, प्लीज आप अपने आप को यस बोलिए. कविता जी बोलिए, क्वेश्चन पूछिए. आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही कविता जी, आपकी आवाज बिल्कुल नहीं आ रही है. आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही है कविता जी. आपने म्यूट कर लिया है. वापस मैं आपको अनम्यूट कर रहा हूं. कविता जी बोलिए. आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही, आप मैसेज डाल दीजिए प्लीज, क्योंकि आपकी आवाज बिल्कुल नहीं आ रही, पकड़ नहीं रहा है. आप बात भी कर रहे, पकड़ नहीं रहा है, आपकी एंड से कुछ प्रॉब्लम है.
सर, कैन यू हियर मी?
आई कैन हियर यू. नो प्रॉब्लम, थैंक यू वेरी मच. होप्स आपको ये अच्छा लगा. प्लीज इसको प्रैक्टिस कीजिए. ये बहुत सिंपल योगिक टेक्निक्स बताई हैं ज्योति जी ने बहुत अच्छी तरह से. चेयर पे बैठ के भी हम इजीली सब आसना कर सकते हैं. कैसे करना है वो भी बता दिया है. ठीक है, हम बहुत जल्दी मिलेंगे. थैंक यू वेरी मच. बाय.